I was traveling about a week ago, and on the plane, I watched this TV show called Young Rock.
Back then, I had a long and uncertain road ahead of me.
Son, you work by the hour, not by the envelope.
That was my first time watching this show, and to be honest with you, it's actually a decent show. And they use these very easy flashback effect a lot in the show, and I'm gonna show you how to do that in Final Cut Pro. So you have two clips on the timeline. One will be a clip showing the present time, your main shot, and the one will be the clip showing a scene that happened before in the past. Just go to the transition tab right here and search for flash. And the one that will give you the effect that they're using in the show is this one, flash, right? Not the flashback, I don't really like the flashback effect right here, but this one will do. So double click on this and let's see how that looks like. Pretty good. There is actually that blending effect in there, that luma blending effect. The other effect is gonna be a simple fade to white effect. You can search fade to color and then apply it as a transition to your clips. And then go to the inspector tab, and that's very important, guys. You can always go to the inspector tab just to see what are some of the options you have there to tweak and just to really control the effect or the transition. And in the inspector tab, you can change the color to white. The midpoint slider right here will be controlling the placement of the full solid white color in the transition, because it's gonna gradually fade into white and then from white to the next clip. So if I put this at, let's say, 90, that means pure white will be close to the end of the transition, because it's the position. This slider right here controls the position of the pure white or the solid white. The hold slider is controlling how long the transition will stay pure white, or the color you pick. If it's not white, then it's whatever color you pick. So if I slide this to 100, the transition will be totally white from the start to the end. Okay, pretty self-explanatory. Now, if you crop or just reduce the size of the transition, you will actually have this faster transition effect. The transition will happen faster, which is exactly what we're trying to do. Now, just don't make it too fast because it doesn't look good, so you'll have to play around with it. To really sell the effect of this transition though, you're gonna have to use a sound effect, and the sound effect is probably half of the effect or even more. And I'm gonna use this one right here, and I'm gonna leave a download link in the description if you want the same sound effect that I'm using. It's free, so you can use it. But let's check how that one sounds like. And there you go, guys. That's it. If you guys got any value from this video, go check out these tips for Final Cut Pro users. Subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one, hopefully. Peace.